Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer, and every Wednesday I give you guys some YouTube tips. Today, let's talk about writing tags for your videos. Now, if you guys have read the YouTube Creator Playbook, especially the one that came out like a couple years ago, the first version that came out, they said something very interesting. They said in there that the order of your YouTube tags does matter, and I'm gonna talk about whether they still do or not. But basically what they said is that you wanna put your most important tags at the beginning because the algorithm weighs more heavily on the first couple tags that are added to a video than the last couple tags. And so for many years, a lot of us creators have been following that advice here on YouTube, but over the past, I don't know, year and a half or so, I've started to suspect that maybe that's not true anymore and that YouTube actually doesn't really care what order you put your tags in. And so last week when I saw buried away in one of YouTube's official help pages that is no longer the case, that the order of your tags does not matter, I was like, I told you so, I knew it. And so no, the order of your tags no longer matters. Now, along with that though, is it used to be that people would fill out that space with as many tags as you could give it. And that was also a recommended practice in one of the earlier versions of the YouTube Creator Playbook. They said, litter it with as many tags that are as appropriate, both specific and generic tags. And the specific and generic tags thing is also true, but apparently Google is getting smarter and smarter, actually figuring out what your video is about, where they don't need you to litter like tons and tons of tags in the tag field of your video when you upload it. Now, I don't think it hurts to still do that, but what YouTube recommends now is that you think about how would you describe this video to your friends? Like what words would you use to describe it to that person? And then just include those words as tags for your video. They say just be succinct. Now, another common question along with this was, Tim, how much do tags actually influence how well a video ranks in search results? And the answer, according to Google, is now that it helps it, like helps Google know initially how to rank your video, and it gives them some initial signals about what your content is about. And then after they start getting better signals from like watch time and what people are clicking on, like if this is related to that video, then they know like there's a kind of a correlation between those two, or if people who are searching for a certain query then actually spend a lot of time watching your video, then they know that that video is related to that query. And so the metadata is important. When the video first gets published, but maybe after a week or so, depending on how much views and traffic you're getting on your content, that metadata becomes less important, which kind of makes sense in the bigger picture of the direction that YouTube and Google have been going. People often dependent on keyword tools and fine-tuning their description text, just altering little words here and there and wordsmithing like everything to be as perfectly optimized as possible. And it's been my experience here on YouTube that it doesn't have to be perfectly optimized in order for it to do well, because Google is really good at figuring out what content is valuable based on what people are watching and clicking on, what they're searching for, how much time they're spending on different videos, and so on. Like for example, I have a video here on this channel called How to Grow with Zero Views and Zero Subscribers. That is a very non-perfectly optimized title, yet it's doing very well because Google knows that this video is valuable for people who are looking for how to get views, how to get subscribers. Or for another example, maybe you'll find that when you search, say, YouTube for music videos, what you get is Billboard Top 100. Those keywords don't match at all, yet Google is smart in knowing what the user's intent is, and they have found that a lot of people who are searching for music videos are also, you know, the good result for that is Billboard Top 100. So for those of you guys who are like diving deep into your keyword analytic tools and all that type of stuff, this is going to drive you crazy. For the rest of us who are like me, just be like, meh, I make good content the best that I can. I put some titles, description tags, thumbnail that accurately represent the video and are also enticing for people to click on, and I just call it good, like those more creative type people and less analytical type people, then we will definitely welcome this change. I'll put links in the description text of this video here on YouTube that go to the official YouTube help pages that talk about this in case you don't want to take my word for it. And I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments below about what you think about this change. How is that going to influence what you do with your channels and your content as you write that data for YouTube and all this stuff? I'd really love to hear from you guys in the comments below. And if this topic is of interest to you, definitely go down there and read the comments that people are leaving. Always really good, helpful stuff from you guys here on the Video Creators community. And if this is your first time here, I'd love to have you subscribe every week, give you guys some YouTube tips and ideas, suggestions and advice, kind of like this one. Tomorrow on Thursday, I'll do some YouTube Q&A with you guys, where I'll take a question that one of you guys has about your channel and audience development, and then I'll answer it for you. And then on Tuesdays, take a look at some of the updates that are happening here on YouTube all the time. We do our best to stay up to date with all the changes that are happening here and how it affects what we're doing. I do all of this because I really believe that a lot of you guys have messages that need to spread, and I want to help you guys reach the people who need to hear what you have to say here on YouTube. So thank you for letting me be a part of that. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Bye.